Hi guys, for the longest time I've been using this little Cerevo Livewedge. This is the thing I use to do all my live mixing, get all the good audio, and use multiple inputs. But I've wanted to be able to use this live switching software and hardware on Facebook Live. And until recently I haven't been able to do that. Well, today I got an email that sent me to this link, this link right here, which shows me how to stream my Cerevo Livewedge to Facebook Live. And I tried it earlier today and it worked great after a little bit of trial and error. And so I'm going to walk you through the steps on how to do that. First, we're going to come back over here to the instructions. There we go. And they say pretty much you go over to your public profile. So not your personal profile. You're going to go up here to publishing tools. Go to video library. Click on live. Down here, you're going to have two separate fields for a URL and the stream key. You're going to want to copy each of these. I'm doing this on my MacBook Pro, and I'm adding it into Google Drive, where I'm adding in the live stream, a URL, and then copying and pasting the live stream key. Now I'm going to take those keys that are here on live stream, and I'm going to come over here to my iPad. We're going to come over here to Docs, where I've got that same thing loaded up, and it's going to see these here in a second. There they are. Okay, so we're going to come up and we're going to copy each line. This takes a little bit more time because my fingers are too chunky. Okay, so you're going to copy that. Come over to the LiveWedge, go into settings. You're going to be in other broadcast services. Click on edit. And on the top line, you're going to put that first bit in, which I think pretty much stays the same all the time, but for this tutorial, I'm just going to walk through all that steps. And on the second layer, you're going to delete your stream, because this will change every time you do a new stream. So it's kind of a pain in the neck, but you still got to change it if you want to do the live stream. And that's when I come back over here to Docs, and I'm going to select all that, come over here to LiveWedge, and paste it in there, save as your default, and then close out that window. Make sure your settings are set up for whatever bandwidth you have. Now, we're going to come back over to the desktop. You're going to click on preview. Now, this may take a few seconds before this comes up. So while it's loading up that information, you're going to want to come over back to your iPad and click on start live. All right, there we go. Now it's starting to get the signal sent out. So it's now sending it over here to Facebook. It's fetching the video stream. There is going to be a delay up here. But while this thing is loading up, you're going to come over here to add your title. And then a little description up here as well. Okay, and then once that is all ready to go. But yeah, that's it. That's all there is to it to make your video go live on Cerevo's LiveWedge. As soon as you're ready, you click on the Go Live button. That's down here. And you'll be ready to rock and roll. Now, live streaming is still kind of in its infancy here between the Cerevo LiveWedge and the Facebook merger. So you gotta test it out a couple times to see what really works for you. Well guys, that's going to do it for me today. If you have any questions about how to live stream with your Cerevo LiveWedge on Facebook, go ahead and take a look at the link below, or you can ask me a question here down in the comment section below. And other than that, guys, I'll talk to you again tomorrow. Take care.